major escalation in tensions between the U.S. and Iran. The top Iranian general has been killed in an airstrike while leaving the Baghdad airport.
For the first time tonight, this, what appears to be the moment that 737 is hit by a missile.
After months on the front lines, today they saw the situation get even worse as a stifling heat wave settled in, stoking the flames.
A U.S. president faces the prospect of impeachment and removal from office.
Desert locusts are eating their way across large parts of East Africa, and it's the worst outbreak.
Now to growing concerns about the deadly coronavirus officially hitting the U.S.
Well, thousands of residents in the Philippines have been ordered to evacuate their homes after a volcano began spewing ash into the sky.
ABC News confirming the five-time NBA champion for Los Angeles Lakers was among five people killed when a helicopter crashed and caught fire in Southern California.
There having been an earthquake in the far eastern province of Turkey, Van.
Dozens of people have been killed after avalanches in both Pakistan and India-controlled Kashmir, according to officials.
Russian Prime Minister Dmitry Medvedev's decision to step down came as a surprise.
11 p.m. in London.
Seek any damages. The proposed Middle East.
A woman is dead and five others injured after a man opened fire on a Greyhound bus.
Two people are dead, another injured after a shooting at Texas A&M's Commerce campus.
The Iowa caucus is in chaos this morning after the Iowa Democratic Party says
in the last half hour, the U.S. Senate has found President Trump not guilty of abuse of power and the obstruction of Congress in his historic impeachment trial.
The first in the deadly coronavirus outbreak. The U.S. Embassy in Beijing confirmed overnight that the first American has died from the virus at the epicenter in the Chinese city of Wuhan.
So this is what we know. At least three people were shot. Hope Ford is live outside a restaurant at Camp Creek Marketplace. Breaking news from the area of Refinery Road. A gas pipeline fire caused a massive emergency response.
Breaking news involving the Boy Scout, the 110-year-old organization, now proud to remain.
The city says their aging sewer pipes have broken at least six times in the past few months, spilling 211 million gallons of waste into the water.
We're going to turn that to another big story, that shooting at a multi-point brewery facility in Wisconsin.
Government forces in Idlib province over Thursday's airstrike that killed 33 Turkish soldiers and wounded dozens.
È per questo che sto per firmare un provvedimento che possiamo sintetizzare con l'espressione "Io resto a casa".
We had heard an explosion at that time, one large explosion, and then I was on the scene about 20 minutes later, and you can see that they were just starting to get a handle on the scene.
The novel coronavirus has now infected more than 245,000 people around the world, and more than 10,000 have died from it. It now has many pharmaceutical companies trying to develop an effective vaccine to protect people against the virus.
Throughout the night, it is posted on social media, showing fires raging, the COVID-19 is spreading, and the prisoners filming themselves.
The Tokyo Olympics, scheduled in July and August, could be postponed because of the coronavirus. North Korea has fired two deadly ballistic missiles in the second of their mystery long course on Monday to help them take over.
More than a million confirmed cases of COVID-19. The country with the most cases continues to be the U.S., with more than 200,000.
French police have arrested a man who killed two people in a stabbing spree on Saturday. The man used a knife to attack passersby in a shopping center in the southeastern French town of Romans-sur-Isère.
And stay in the Middle East, the Saudi-led military coalition fighting Yemen's Houthi rebels and
a group of police officials was targeted at a vegetable market in Patiala.
A group of people targeted the cops, and in the incident, the hand of our assistant sub-inspector was cut off.
But we begin today another special, where our rural community is trying to come to terms with insurmountable loss.
North Korea's dictator and the control of that country's nuclear weapons is in serious question this morning.